During the crisis, young girls were not thinking about the risk they would have after sleeping with those men. They were only thinking about how to earn money and survive their families. They have to paddle their own canoes to cross the river. I just have to set an instance on my own younger sister, who was 12 and became pregnant during this Ebola outbreak. The mom was no longer going to marketplaces to take care of the family, so she has to help sell cassava bread and cake. And she came across this young man who gave her the impression of buying all her cassava bread in order to impress my younger sister that he can be able to take care of her. Of course, when she was asked who impregnated her, and this young man has to deny the pregnancy, of course, he never answered and he never admitted he was responsible. So I have to foot the responsibility, presently having to take care of the baby, who is now 7 months old. My younger sister has to be transferred to Lonsa to continue her schooling because she's always ashamed to be called a mother. The only thing I can do for her is to help her take care of the baby so that she can continue her education. Being a physical disability woman, if I have not been so strong and decided to do something else in my life, I would have been like a dropped out in society. Life is full of hiccups along the way, but nevertheless, you have to keep the fire burning. You have to just be strong. Be courageous. This is not the end of your life. Just keep your head up to make sure the women are not treated that way any longer. Our culture do encourage people to take care of a baby because the child is not just for one person. Everybody helps to take care of the baby. We choose the name Munda, meaning my own or our own in our own local language in Mende, because in Africa, if there is a husband for a baby, that baby belongs to the husband's family. But if there is no husband, the baby is ours. So we have to claim the baby. He's ours. So we call him Munda, our own. He's for us.